off as Jerry Springer's bodyguard in 1994. Seems like a lifetime ago. Steve joins us now from New York City to talk about what is new this season. How about it? Lucky number 13.
Yeah, it is crazy. I always tell the story that I went to work on the Springer show for one day, and 25 years I'm still here, so it's kind of crazy. But yeah, we're going into our 13th season. During this season, we're going to hit our 2000th show, which is a big milestone in TV. And this year, we're also incorporating a segment that we're going to put out different shows throughout the year called Steve's Heroes. And it's basically recognizing everyday people that have done something heroic or courageous, saving somebody, helping somebody. And we bring them on the show and recognize them and give them a little reward. And it's good for me because sometimes my show can be very hard-edged and I'm the tough guy, but this is a chance to recognize somebody that has stepped in a very tough situation and did something very good for somebody else.
Yeah, and I think that for those that don't know a lot about you, that also is very important to you because if my memory serves me right, aren't you a veteran and a former police officer as well?
Yeah, I served 6.5 years in the Marine Corps, and then I was a Chicago police officer for 12 years.
So let's talk a little bit about that. You know, you have family, too, that still works on the show, right? So this has become even, I think about all the hours and all the years that you've worked, and like you said, some of the topics of the show, I can only imagine what they kind of do to your brain. I mean, we know part of it is entertainment, but part of it is, you know, social.
Well, being a police officer in Chicago, you know, that's a very tough job. But it really, I could never have gotten a talk show and did this type of show if I never was a policeman, because the policeman trained me to talk to people, get out the story, find out what's happening and solve the problem. And even though I'm not a policeman anymore, I still feel like I'm a cop on my stage. Mm. And my wife is my executive producer, so we've been working together probably for 24 years now between the Springer Show and my show. So it's great having her because she guides me a lot to where the show needs to go. And there's times when I feel like I need to go in a different direction and she lets me go there. So we've been very fortunate to have this interesting combination of a talk show host and executive producer being married to each other. But again, I really believe that because remember, most people who get TV shows are celebrities. Mm-hmm. They don't give them to Chicago policemen. So like I said, and we can only do this show. This show is basically me being a policeman on stage, and it's worked because I was a policeman.
I like that analogy. Hey, we'll be watching, and good luck for maybe, I don't know, 13 more seasons? Could happen.
Until my son gets out of college, the very least.
Okay, we got to pay the bills. All right, hey, we'll see you. Yes. Thanks for joining us. 9:44 right now. Let's talk heat and humidity coming back or staying around. Right, Tim?
Yeah, it looks like it, Ange, a little bit hotter.